579. O God, our help in ages past.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, everyone. Welcome. Brothers and sisters, let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess,
Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
We praise you,
we bless you,
we adore you,
we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Tonight's readings can be found on page 213 in the Companion Missal. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. I prayed, and prudence was given me. I pleaded, and the spirit of wisdom came to me. I preferred her to scepter and throne, and deemed riches nothing in comparison with her. Nor did I liken any priceless gem to her. because all gold in view of her is a little sand. And before her, silver is to be accounted mire. Beyond health and comeliness, I loved her, and I chose to have her rather than the light, because the splendor of her never yields to sleep. Yet all good things together came to me in her company, and countless riches at her hands. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, indeed, the word of God is living and effective, sharper than any two-edged sword, penetrating even between soul and spirit, joints and marrow, and able to discern reflections and thoughts of the heart. No creature is concealed from him, but everything is naked and exposed to the eyes of him to whom we must render an account. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus was setting out on a journey, a man ran up, knelt down before him, and asked him, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus answered him, "Why do you call me good? No one is good but God alone. You know the commandments. You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness. You shall not defraud. Honor your father and your mother." He replied and said to him, "Teacher, all of these I have observed from my youth." Jesus, looking at him, loved him and said to him, "You are lacking in one thing. Go, sell what you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me." At that statement, his face fell, and he went away sad, for he had many possessions. Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, "How hard it is for those who have wealth to enter the kingdom of God." The disciples were amazed at his words. So Jesus again said to them in reply, "Children, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for one who is rich to enter the kingdom of God." They were exceedingly astonished and said among themselves, "Then who can be saved?" Jesus looked at them and said, "For human beings it is impossible, but not for God. All things are possible for God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Can you hear me in the back there? May the Lord give you his peace. A very special word of welcome to all of you. And those who are watching the homily over the internet, hello there. Welcome. One of the themes that comes up in so many places in the Bible comes up again in today's gospel, which I just love. It's the idea that this life is a journey. This life is a journey. I absolutely love that theme. And you'll even find it in many places in the catechism, which really confirms for us our experience of life. It says in the Catechism that God has created life on this planet in the state of journey. Isn't that true? It's true. The sun goes up. The sun goes down. Tomorrow comes. Summer turns into fall, turns into winter, turns into spring, turns into summer. Right? You start out like a little baby. You get a little older, your hair starts turning gray, you stop growing up and you start growing out, and then for us guys, our hair starts falling out, you know, like, there's a journey that we're on. Such a powerful theme, and I love when I'm preaching and I look out at the church and I see there's some young people here. Some of my favorite young people from the Bronx are here. So great to see you at Mass. There's some young at heart who are here as well. And we're here together, huh? And I want to connect this theme of the journey, that life is a journey, with some very powerful words which were spoken to us recently by Pope Francis. Is anyone here able to attend or watch the Mass at Madison Square Garden? Did you catch the homily? Now, the translation during the Mass was a little off, but if you get a chance to go back and read the homily that Pope Francis gave at Madison Square Garden, speaking to those of us who live here in New York, he had a very powerful message. And what he said, he acknowledged how difficult big cities can be, how many people have the experience of feeling quite lonely in big cities. And then he kind of like compared that to people who feel lonely in life. And I feel the connection there with the idea that life is a journey is so important for us to remember
that it's not a journey we make alone. It's not a journey we make alone. First of all, we have our families that we journey with. And then we have our parish. We have our friends. And ultimately, we have God Himself. You know, there are many places in the gospel where it makes a comment, Jesus looked at him or them. It says here, Jesus looked at him with love. God sees us. He looks at us with love and he is with us. So here we are. Here we are. We're on this journey. Some of you are just kind of in the beginning stages of that journey. Maybe some of us are at the end stages of that journey. I think most of us are somewhere in the middle and not sure where we are. But God is with us. What do we need to do with this time? What is it that we're called to do? That's the question this rich young man asked. And remember, the riches that Jesus warns about is when you don't own things, but they own you. And that you put your trust in things and not in God. That's what he's calling out there. But we're here, we're together on this journey to live good lives. It's not just about staying away from bad things. Thou shalt not, thou shalt not, thou shalt not. But when you get a little older, you start to realize even more than that, it's about what we are to do. You know, to live a life of love, a life of mercy, a life that reaches out towards others, a life where we make efforts to be friends to others, to be there for others, and to have people around us who love us, who are there for us, that we're together on this journey with one another and with God. And let's pray for the grace to be more aware, to be more sensitive to the ways that God is active in our life, through relationships, through prayer, that we make good use for this time that we are given in this journey, and that we may live lives of love. And that's really what it's all about. And we pray for that grace this night. Amen. We'll now have the profession of the creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we offer our prayers to God, we seek not worldly benefit, but the wisdom and splendor it yields as we pray.
That the Church will continue to act as a mediator in finding solutions to problems affecting peace and social harmony, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That young people will overcome fears and answer God's vocational call, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the people, enduring the results of the South Carolina floods, will receive the moral and economic support that they will need to help them manage their catastrophic losses. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and the homebound, and for all those we have promised to remember, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are lonely and forgotten in life and in death, for those who have gone before us in faith, especially Thomas Barry, and those who have lost their lives as victims of disease, violence, accident, or war, that they may be received by Christ and given peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own personal intentions, we now pause to pray in the quiet of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, teach us to look within to discover the splendor of wisdom and help us to see the new opportunities each unfolding moment brings. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Of all holiness. Holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Timothy our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Jesus shines brighter.
Let us pray. entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Kindly be seated for a few announcements.
Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Louise Ullman, and I'm a member of the Joy J Initiative. It's a pastoral program up at Blessed Sacrament on the Upper West Side. The goal of the Joy J is to follow Jesus' commandment to love one another as I have loved you. And with this in mind, we take comfort bags filled with items to our less fortunate brothers and sisters who live on the streets. Once I was on the street and I found a man lying on a cardboard box, face down. I wasn't sure if he was dead or alive. I went over and I roused him, and thankfully he picked up his head. And I said to him, "I have a sandwich for you." And I took it out of the bag. He ripped it open, and in three or four gulps it was gone, even before I had the chance to take the cap off of the water. And so then I showed him what was in the bag. There were a hat, a scarf, and gloves, and a sweatshirt, and socks, and there was some toiletries, and a prayer card, and information where they can get breakfast, lunch, and dinner every day, shelter, clothing, places where they can get legal assistance to get the Medicare and Medicaid, places where they can even get a shower, a shave, and a haircut. And we were talking back and forth, and then finally I got up and I said, "All right, well," his name was Alex, I learned through the conversation. I said, "Well, Alex, you know, take care of yourself, I'll pray for you." And as I was leaving, he said to me, "What's your name?" And I said, "Louise." And he said, "God bless you, Louise." And I said, "No. God bless you, Alex." I said, "God is going to bring wonderful things your way." And he said, "I hope so, Louise, because this is the hardest thing I've ever had to live through." So, these comfort bags not only bring just a little bit of material items, but it's the humanity that you bring to a person, and they give it back to you. So we're having an outreach here with Our Lady of Good Counsel and St. Thomas More Church on November 7th at 10 a.m. at St. Thomas More Rectory. All the bags will be prepared. There will be leaders to take you out. Everything will be explained to you. You don't have to worry about a thing. You just have to show up. So I'm here tonight seeking some volunteers from Our Lady of Good Counsel. So if you're interested, there's in the back, there are sign-up sheets on the left-hand side, and I'll be back there if there are any questions. And I thank you for your time and your patience, and God bless you. Good night.
Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. Our closing hymn is number 764, God of Our Fathers, number 764. God.